And we will have more on this developing story throughout the bulletin. But to other news now, and a 16-year-old boy is tonight facing the potential of life in prison after being charged with an act of terror over the alleged stabbing of a Sydney bishop. Today we learned more harrowing details about the teen as calls grew louder for tougher knife laws. Some want parents held accountable as police step up their patrols around places of faith.
Midday prayers, but today retaliation fears saw few women on the streets outside Lakemba Mosque.
Women who are identifiable through their headscarf, walking through the streets or shopping centres, they're at the moment they're scared to do that. So we've sent everyone back home today, and that sense of fear is real.
As our top brass confirmed, a 16-year-old boy is now facing a Commonwealth terror charge, accused of this attack on a bishop.
We allege on Monday night that was stabbed up to six times.
Police moved fast after Monday night's horror, retracing the teen's movements.
We also allege that the boy had travelled for 90 minutes to attend that location from his home address.
The next day, counter-terrorism officers searched his home, seizing a number of items, including electronic devices. By yesterday, investigators were holding a special hospital bedside hearing before charging the teenager.
Charged with committing a terrorist act, an offence which carries a maximum penalty of imprisonment for life.
His defence lawyer today telling court this young person is in need of help in relation to a long history of behaviour consistent with suffering a mental illness, which he'd been receiving intermittent treatment for since the age of five.
The terrorist threat in Australia has not changed following this incident. Our national terrorism threat level remains at possible.
Today, police patrolled outside mosques and churches and other areas of faith, patrolling for peace as those inside called for peace. Outside, there are growing calls for tougher knife laws.
We've seized too many knives. If government strengthens those laws, then we'll welcome that.
If parents knowingly let their children out the door with a dangerous weapon like a knife, then yes, they should have the book thrown at them.
Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.